Okay, folks, hold on to your hats because we've got a juicy one here. You've all heard the chatter, right? Meghan Markle, beloved by many, discussed by all, is setting her sights high and making waves. The buzz? Well, she's possibly preparing to take a shot at the big seat. Yep, we're talking about the presidency. And there's more. It's rumored that she's about to hit publish on her very own blog, a venture that's set to net her a cool $200,000 per post. That's right, folks, $200,000 per post. Could it be that our very own Duchess of Sussex is about to don the crown of the blogosphere queen? But here's the zinger. Word has it that Meghan may finally step out of Harry's shadow and ditch him like an old sock. Now, we all love a bit of drama, but it's got us wondering, how can all these things be true at the same time? Well, the answer is they probably can't. Some things have got to give for others to fly. The free wardrobe perks? Nah, can't see that one going. The much-anticipated TIG relaunch and the potential to lose big bucks? Unlikely. And giving up on the dream of gracing the White House as POTUS? Hardly. I mean, every climber has their Everest, and for Meghan, who's been ascending the social ladder with gusto, the White House seems to be her pinnacle. You've got to admit, it's kind of fitting. Meghan, with her forward-thinking, philanthropic heart, might just make the White House her ultimate trophy. But does she need Harry for any of these ambitions? Well, if the rumblings from her PR firm are anything to go by, she's digging this hole herself. Our guy Harry's been holding the spade, sure, but Meghan's the one calling the shots. Yet, there's an elephant in the room. Spotify exec Bill Simmons labeled them as a power duo. But with all these rumors flying around, could this be the end of the most beautiful love story ever told? The echo of history's cruel circumstances ripping apart our modern-day Abelard and Heloise? But let's not forget, Abelard wrote, "The History of My Calamities," a medieval tell-all and a beacon for committed feminists and advocates for women's education. Much like Harry. Just something to mull over with your morning coffee, folks. Now here's a wild thought. Remember how Abelard was, altered for his romance? Some folks are suggesting Harry's been metaphorically emasculated in his relationship. And Meghan? Well, she's been portrayed as this incredibly intelligent student, just like Heloise, and eventually became his wife. Deja vu, anyone? But hold up a second. Harry isn't quite the philosopher Abelard was. And let's be honest, he's not known for penning heartfelt love letters either. The couples claimed their IQ scores are soaring, but who are we kidding here? So, no more passing the salt and pepper at the dinner table. Could it be that Meghan, famously known for holding onto Harry tighter than a koala to a eucalyptus tree, is ready to leave him high and dry? Remember the good old days when Harry wouldn't stop gushing about how smitten he was with Meghan? And she echoed those sentiments. So, what gives? According to reputation crisis guru Eric Schiffer, Meghan's attempting to put some distance between her and her past. And does that past include Harry? Breaking up? Possibly. According to Eric, the signs are there. It's no coincidence that she skipped the coronation and chose not to accompany Harry to court recently. Meghan's no stranger to forging ahead and navigating away from drama. She's got her compass set on progress, not the past. And if that's her game plan, well, it's not a half bad one. People are getting tired of Harry playing the blame game with the press for his past woes and constantly bringing up stories from what feels like a century ago. What's he thinking? Meghan's probably trying to recapture the positive vibe that made her so appealing to the younger generations in the first place, getting back to the image of a strong, independent woman on the move. Ah, the vision of a successful, empowered woman. The kind of woman who builds her own career, who's ready to tackle serious women's issues while also bringing some levity and ambition to the table. Who could resist that kind of magnetic pull? Our very own Meghan seems to have channeled the spirit of her late mother-in-law, the much-loved Diana. But alas, it looks like Prince Harry may have had his last heart-pounding, paparazzi-filled car chase. No more PTSD flashbacks triggered by the sound of a moped exhaust. The perpetual glare of the press spotlight, which has for so long been focused on Meghan, can now be turned off. And who will she have left to blame for all her troubles? Why, none other than her supposed one true love, of course. Ironically, it seems like WME is discarding the very bricks that Meghan used to climb to where she is today. Bricks provided by Harry, no less. But there's a speed bump in these grand plans. You see, the Gen X and Gen Z crowd aren't buying this gold digger narrative. In their eyes, Megan has clawed her way from being a barely memorable actress to the, oh my gosh, I can't believe this is happening to me level of fame. And they aren't having it. Harry was never the main event. It was always about his royal platform. Megan rode that platform all the way to her current position, and she's now ready to stand on her own two feet. Yet, she's likely to hold on to her Duchess title, eager to steer clear from the mediocrity of her past. It seems her minions are prepped and ready to roll without Harry. The chatter about Meghan creating some distance from the self-inflicted drama is growing louder. The debacle they've created is starting to backfire. And if that doesn't give us a clear picture of how Meghan plans to proceed, I don't know what does. She spotted another stepping stone on that social ladder she's so eager to climb, and it bears a striking resemblance to Harry's head. But hey, that's showbiz for you, right? Listen, no one's arguing that Meghan's got the voice of an angel or the intellect of Einstein. What she does have is a knack for making connections with those she believes will boost her status. Fame didn't come easy for her. She wasn't born an international star. She found her footing later in life, largely due to her royal connections. I mean, who knows what she thought she'd gain by marrying Harry? A cozy cottage life? A life dedicated to royal duty? Only she can answer that. And let's take a moment to appreciate the late queen's subtle genius. Her decisions certainly revealed quite a bit about the couple's motives, don't you think? Let's not forget the couple's ambitious plan to establish a new royal court in the U.S. A plan that, let's be real, was doomed from the start. Remember the awkwardness at the polo match? Meghan in that eye-catching red dress and hat, and Harry with his odd request to play the British anthem at an American event for veterans, the numerous podcasts, interviews, the infamous South Park episode, and then the golden suit and Hertz deal. It all led up to a messy, almost catastrophic end. And through all this, Harry still manages to look miserable while Meghan never misses a chance to strike a pose for the cameras. Hey, Harry, isn't it time you face the reality of your situation? Brits understand the game. It's all a part of Meghan's master plan. If she decides to go solo, Harry may very well find himself out of the public eye for good. But hey, the show must go on, right? Keep the conversation going in the comments, and feel free to share this with anyone you think might get a kick out of it. And if you've enjoyed our videos, be sure to check back on the Royal News Channel for more juicy updates in the future.